major difference, I would say, between a food allergy and a food intolerance is a food intolerance is going to be a little bit milder in nature. So maybe some GI discomfort, maybe constipation, diarrhea, whereas a food allergy can be much more intense, you know, up to anaphylactic shock. So it could be respiratory distress, swelling of the airways, that kind of thing. So there are 8 most common food allergies. They happen to be milk, eggs, peanuts, tree nuts, soy, wheat, seafood, and fish. If you are the parent of a young child, a first-time parent, let's say, and there's a history of food allergies, the new guidelines, particularly research done with peanuts, it shows that if you can introduce the food under the guidance of your pediatrician or an allergist within 4 to 6 months of childhood, you could actually resolve that food allergy earlier in life or at least develop a tolerance to the food into adulthood. If you want to know if a food allergy has resolved into adulthood, you want to, under the guidance of your physician, do a food challenge. And basically, it's taking a small portion of that food that you're allergic to and testing to see if your symptoms or your signs and your symptoms are mild or severe. From there, you can gauge if you've developed a tolerance to that food you were once allergic to. So if you are allergic to a food, you want to take certain measures to make sure that you can avoid that food. You know, there is no cure for a food allergy. There's only preventative measures we can take. So you want to read your food labels. You want to become familiar. Maybe visit a dietitian so you can learn how to do so. You want to meal prep without cross-contaminating with the allergic food. When you go out to restaurants, tell your server, I'm allergic to this. You know, please let the chef know in the back. Make sure that everyone knows that you are allergic to a food.